Good morning and welcome to Berks Heim at Work in our community. My name is Ann Gilmer and I'm the Director of Volunteers. Unfortunately, my guest today, or my partner today, Ann Semmel, is not feeling well, so she's home, and I just want to start out by saying, hi Annie, I hope you're feeling better soon. There's so much stuff going around right now that it's almost everybody has felt sick at one point, so I hope she's doing better. And for today's show, it's usually a show that we do in January, but we had a delay getting on. So even though it's further removed from the holiday season, we still wanted to share our holiday review with you. And really, a lot of it is because we want to be able to let you know about all the great community outreach and the giving and caring that we get at Berks Heim from the community. We too often hear all these bad news stories, and sometimes it gets a little depressing and you think, what's happening? But I can assure you, for one, that there is a lot of good news out there in our community, a lot of good people who do a lot of good things. And at Berks Heim, we are very fortunate to be on the receiving end of many kind deeds and kind people. Especially during the holidays, of course, our volunteers are faithful year-round, but the holidays, of course, are a busier time, and so our volunteers are spending more time at Berks Heim, putting in a lot more hours and doing a lot more things to enable us to be able to make a nice holiday season for our residents, and also members of the community, whether it's individuals or businesses or schools or church groups. We are fortunate to receive the kindness from all those types of groups. Now, for as far as the holiday season, we usually kick it off with Santa's Corner, which is in the beginning of December. And Santa's Corner is the event very popular with our residents, where they are able to come down to our auditorium, where we have a large array of items categorized throughout the auditorium that they can shop and pick a gift for themselves. And we need a lot of volunteers, and we get a lot of donations for that particular event. So I have a few pictures of Santa's Corner here. This is showing some of the students that come in. We have students from Topahawken, honor students, that come in to help out with this event. And we also have students from the Berks Career and Technology Center. We may have 40 to 50 students who will come in that day, which is wonderful because it is a large event. We do need a lot of help. And things that they do, they spend most of the day with us, is they will help to bring the residents down to the auditorium and assist them with shopping if they need assistance. They also help to serve snacks. And in this picture here, you can see students sitting around with some residents and getting to spend some time chatting, which the residents enjoy so much. They love talking to the younger generations and sharing stories, seeing what it's like to be in high school these days, and maybe sharing some stories of when they were in high school. So it's a nice experience, really, for both groups. And it, like I said, it is a popular event. What's nice is that here you can see the students helping to shop and some of the items displayed. We receive money from our volunteer service board, which does fundraising throughout the year for the benefit of our residents. But we also receive donations of items from individuals, maybe a small group of coworkers at a business will decide to donate items. And things that they donate can include anything from clothing items all the way to things like adult coloring books and markers, things that are popular pastime of our residents. And we have another volunteer here who is going to help with the snacks as well. So we have our regular faithful volunteers that come in. That mix in with the extra volunteers that come over the holiday. the students really enjoy this event too. They look forward to it every year. And I think it's always so nice that when they're leaving at the end of the day, they'll always say, we'll see you next year. So I know that I can count on them again. And we have Santa and Mrs. Claus, so residents can visit with Santa, get a picture taken if they like to. And these are volunteers, Jan and Carrie Coker, who come in every year and volunteer their time for this event, which just is a nice extra touch. Students also will help to wrap gifts as well as other volunteers. Once the resident picks out their gift, we do wrap it for them. So on occasion, someone won't want it wrapped, but most of the time they enjoy getting it wrapped, and then they may wait closer to Christmas and open the gift. And on occasion, they may get something for a family member too. So that's another busy section of Santa's Corner is wrapping the gifts. And then some of the residents, like I said, along with the students who are helping them with their shopping, will pose. And this is a group of, the Berks Career and Technology group of students who pose for a picture for us before they're out and about and doing everything that they do to help with that event. And then this is the Topohokan Honor students who come in. So you can see, it's a large group of students, and they really help to make Santa's Corner a success. It is one of our favorite events, as I mentioned. And here we have some more pictures of the residents and even family members. Then the next thing that we have during the holidays is we have our unit Christmas parties. And we divide it into two different days because we do have over 400 residents. And we have what we call our A side party and our B side party. This year, our entertainment was really great. Again, Topohokan students provided that. And for one of the day's parties, we had the Topohokan High School Show Choir. And they really do a great job singing and doing their dance routines. And the residents really, really enjoyed that entertainment. So we have different pictures showing the routines that they did. Really putting on a great show. Now, I think this was a slightly smaller version of the show choir, simply so that they could fit into the auditorium with all the residents that were there to watch them. They did a really great job. Very lively group, very entertaining. And then on the second day, the second party that we had, the Topohokan Jazz Band came and performed for the residents. And that was a really great show as well. They really, really sounded great. Residents really enjoyed that. And you can see we had big crowds for both parties. Some of the students had solos, so it was really... And there was a vocalist too. So it was really enjoyable. Quite a large group too. I was surprised. Now, we also are fortunate to be able to give names out in the community to some groups, churches, some county departments who have angel trees. I know for the county, they do for children and they do for seniors. And so we give our list of names for those of residents who might not have family, might not get a gift otherwise. And then the staff members pick a name and make a purchase based on what the resident is requesting and really wrap the gifts up beautifully. And so for the county departments, the sheriff's department delivered the gifts to us. And we see the sheriff's car coming there, but no worries, it was for a good cause. Here you can see they're loading up the gifts. It was quite a few gifts. So I think they made several trips in to Berks Heim with all the packages. Now, those gifts are held until Christmas Day, and then our activity staff goes to those residents and delivers the gifts to them on Christmas Day itself. Just showing some of our trees that we had decorated throughout the facility. Another donation that we received from the community was from the Reading Royals organization. They had their teddy bear toss. Apparently it was an extremely successful event because they were able to deliver the stuffed animals throughout the community. And Berks Heim was fortunate to be one of the locations where they donated the stuffed animals. And we actually got enough animals to be able to give one to every resident. We have over 400 residents, so that was quite a donation and very popular with the residents. Then we always have our annual tissue drive, and that is something that we do in order to be able to give every resident a box of tissues for Christmas. So again, we had donations from throughout the community, from businesses, church groups, and also individuals. And this group, which was the, I have to find my time, I want to make sure I get their name right. This was the Albright Soccer Academy group. And not only did they collect tissues for our drive, but they made a poster up, which was really sweet. Like a big Christmas greeting, and all of the students signed it. So we were sure to hang that up in our main hallway so that all the residents, that's a busy thoroughfare, and so our residents, visitors, family members could all get to see this poster-sized greeting card. So we were able to reach our goal and able to give all of our residents a box of tissues too on Christmas. So the activity staff went around with the Christmas gifts and the tissues and made sure that the residents got them on Christmas Day. So that was just another sample of all the community outpouring that we received. And in addition to that, we had groups that came in and did Christmas caroling throughout the month. Small groups from churches to large groups. We have a group that comes in every year. They've been doing that for quite a few years now, and it's a group of homeschooled children that come in, and they love coming in and singing for the residents. They go throughout the facility, as most of those who come in to sing will do. They'll go and sing for maybe 15 minutes on a unit and then move to another unit and so on till they get through the building. And the homeschoolers are children, you know, from elementary age through high school. And I know one of the mothers, you know, there are adults, of course, mothers who come in and accompany them. And she told me that one of her children was sick and couldn't come, and they were extremely disappointed. They really enjoy coming in, and we love having them. So there was a lot of caroling that was done by volunteers, and it was just a very special time with the holidays for our residents. Again, thanks to the community outreach. There's a lot of good people out here in Berks County who do a lot of good things, that's for sure. Another donation that we received was the Reading Eagle had their Socks for Seniors drive. And we were fortunate to be one of the recipients of those donations as well. And some of our residents were even featured in a little story on in the Reading Eagle's Christmas Day edition, which showed some of the residents receiving the socks. And I know they really liked that and appreciated it. There was a huge variety, and you know, they got to choose what kind they like. So that was also very nice, and we were very grateful for that. In addition, of course, we had entertainment, and one of the groups that I want to show is the Reading Acapella Voices. They are a part of the Reading Pagoda Singers, and they came in to sing for the residents. They did a really great job too, And Sandy Graffius, who is the county controller, is in that group, and she also likes to throw in some humor with their singing, so she'll, in between songs, she'll tell the residents some jokes, and they enjoyed that program. This picture is of our Berks Heim Bell Ringers. Now, the Bell Ringers is a group of residents, and they practice hard to get to learn songs, and they came in and they actually performed. So they played Christmas songs for the enjoyment of the residents who were there. They're doing a really great job. It's a fairly new group, maybe a year and a half, 2 years, I'm sort of guessing. But, and that group has grown too, so they enjoy it. They get, we have a large screen TV which puts the song up and you know, shows the notes that are to be played, and then they, you know when to go in and do their ringing. So it's very interesting. It's a nice event. Oh, and then of course we also had the Ugly Christmas Shirt Day, and that was open to residents and staff and visitors, and I got the one picture here of the staff person who won. She actually has like an actual package connected to her shirt. So we had a lot of creative shirts. That was a lot of fun too. And that's something that we've been doing annually as well, the Ugly Shirt Contest. Then just to show something that's a little more recent, we had our NFL dress-up day last week, the Friday before the Super Bowl. Of course, we had a lot of people who were excited about the Eagles being in the Super Bowl this year. And although not all of our staff are Eagles fans, everybody got to wear, you know, their shirt for whatever team they root for. But it was extra exciting this year with the Eagles. We had a lot, got a lot of shots of those with their Eagles shirts, or competitors, friends, but not maybe agreement on who they like for football. And here we have the Eagles and Patriots together. Well, so it's good that we can still smile and be together like that. And we also have another shot here of sibling rivalry, where we have an Eagles fan and a non-Eagles fan. I'm sorry, I don't know what team that jersey is from that she's wearing, but we know who won that game, so it was exciting. We're glad to see that the Eagles won, for all you Eagles fans who are out there as well. They deserved it. They were a great team this year. So that was another event. That was fun. Now, what we're getting ready, you know, one of our bigger events that's coming up in the near future is our volunteer luncheon. Well, actually it's in April, but that'll be here before you know it. And it's a fun event. It's one of the things that we really look forward to, getting all of our volunteers together and being able to thank them in a special way with a gathering. So right now we're in the planning stages of our theme and our menu, and that's something that we look forward to. Something that we will be able to discuss further in our next show, which is April, when we come back again. And I also want to thank some of the, I have some new volunteers who are coming in, and I want to thank them for joining our team. We have a lot of great volunteers, but you can never have enough volunteers. That's one thing you just can never have enough of. So, if you are interested in volunteering, if it's something you've been thinking about, something you'd like to consider, please contact me at Berks Heim. You can call our main number, which is 610-376-4841, and just let the operator know you're interested in volunteering, and she'll connect you with me. I would be glad to meet with you, show you around the facility if you're not familiar with it. Let you know what volunteer opportunities we have, and see what we can fit you for, something that's you would enjoy, something that you can get, you know, fit into your schedule, because we do need volunteers 7 days a week, and we need them in the mornings, the afternoons, and the evenings. So that, I think, helps to make it more flexible for the volunteer. I know sometimes there are places that if they're only open Monday through Friday and that's when you work, it would be difficult, if, well, impossible for you to be able to volunteer, but we do have all those available times. So please contact me, and I would be glad to talk to you about that. And we look forward to 2018 and all the events and get-togethers and volunteer sharing that we'll have for this year. And we hope to hear from you as a new volunteer. And we again thank our volunteers who continue to be faithful to us. And we want to thank the community for their outpouring of donations, their time, and their kindness. So I'd like to say goodbye for now, and we will see you again in April. Good.